Hey guys, good morning. Today we are going to discuss 802.11 power management. So these are the outlines. First of all, we will look into the introduction part, then basic power management steps, what is association ID, what is door state, what is TIM, DTIM, all the stuff. Okay, so coming to the introduction part, this wireless radio can perform one of the following listed four activities. So power consumed by each activity increases in the given order. So that is 1 to 4. First is asleep mode, then idle and awake. The third one is receiving, and the last one is transmitting. So if you look at this power consumption by each activity increases in this order. Okay, so basically there are three methods of power management. The first one is 802.11 power management, which is nothing but the legacy power saving mechanism. Second one is UAPSD, unscheduled automatic power safe delivery. Okay. And the third one is PSMP, power safe multipole, which is implemented in 802.11 and amendment. They are the basic power management steps. Basic power management structure can be summarized into the four steps. The first of all is before a station goes into the door state, it has to send a frame, usually a null data frame, to the AP, indicating that power management bit is enabled. Power management is enabled. Once station indicates that it is in power saving mode, the AP begins to buffer all frames destined to that particular station. When the station goes into awake state, it sends a frame to the AP in order to begin the data retrieval process. This is the third step. And the last one is, when AP has finished sending all buffer data to the station again goes back into the door state. So these are the basic power management steps. Then we will look into this, what is association identifier and how it comes into picture. Every 802.11 power management method begins when the station associates to the basic service set, that is BSS. Okay. So when an AP sends an association response frame to the station, an association identifier value present in the association ID fixed parameter field, that is 16 bit. So once the station will associate with an AP, AP will assign an identifier that is called association identifier, in short AID, which is of 16 bit value. So this association ID is present in association response and reassociation response frames. So basically when you look at here, I will take the laser pointer. Just we'll move to the previous slide. Here you can see that this is a management frame which is association response. Okay, and here is the association ID marked. Okay. Coming to the next slide, what is DoorState? DoorState is nothing but a station is allowed to go to the DoorState after the AP has been notified that station is about to enter the power cell. Okay. Station will use null data frame with power management bit set to 1, that is PM bit set to 1. Here you can see this is a null data frame, and here the power management bit power save mode is set to 1. Station will wake up from the DoorState for one of the two reasons. If station has a frame to send, otherwise based on the station internal timing mechanism. So basically for these two states, station wakes up. What is traffic indication map? As the name suggests, your traffic indication map. See, this is a traffic indication map. This is an information element, that is IE, with the following subfields. The first one is element ID. Element ID is of size 1 byte. Here if you will see value 5 indicate it as a dim. So if the element ID is 5, which means we will come to know that this is a dim information element. Then the second is called the length. Length is also of 1 byte. So basically the length of the information carrying fields, that is DTIM count, DTIM period, bitmap control and the partial virtual bitmap, PVB. Coming to the DTIM count. DTIM count is of size 1 byte. So which means incremental beacon frames until the next DTIM. Okay, I will explain you once I will describe all this. What is that? DTIM period. This DTIM period is of 1 byte. Number of beacon frames between DTIM beacon. Okay. Bitmap control 1 byte. To indicate multicast or broadcast, our buffer at the AP and use as space saver. Okay. Bitmap offset. This partial virtual bitmap. Okay. Let's look one by one. What is this? Why this came into picture? See, first of all, station associated with the AP, and after that AP assigned an association ID to the station. Okay. So if there is no data send and receive is happening, station can go into the power save mode. Okay. So when it will wake up from the power save mode? At a particular time interval, that is in the listen interval. So listen interval will come into picture. So listen interval will come into picture from the station side. Okay, I think I didn't mention over here, but I can tell it to you. So the station will wake up at a particular listen interval. Okay. So when the station will wake up at a particular listen interval, it has to check the beacon whether any dim bit is set for me or not. If the dim bit is set for that particular association ID, then it will come to know that, hey, there is some data buffer for me, so I have to retrieve that data. So in this way, this is worked out. So here we are looking to the dim bit, how it looks like. So this is basically the dim frame format. So basically it's consists of 6 subfields. So the first subfield is element ID. Element ID is nothing but to indicate a particular IE, it has to given some number. So for this timbit, this is set to 5. Length field, it has to this field carries the this field carries all the length of the remaining fields, that is DTIM count, DTIM period, etc. Okay, coming to DTIM count, that is incremental beacon frames until the next DTIM. For example, let's say for an example DTIM value is 3. So this DTIM count will go on changing, first 3, then 2, then 1. Then when 0 will encounter, that time you will come to know that this is a DTIM beacon. Okay, then the DTIM period. DTIM period is nothing but the example whatever I told, that is the DTIM period 3. So this DTIM period is fixed, but DTIM count is going to change. Bitmap control. So this bitmap control is the field which will indicate that any multicast or broadcast data are buffered at the end. Okay, and also it uses as space save. Coming to the partial virtual bitmap, so here this consists of 1 to 251 byte. So there are some series of flags indicating whether each associated station has unicast frames buffered at the AP. So each bit in this field corresponds to a AID of a station. So basically this total consists of 1 to 251 byte, and each particular byte indicates for a particular association ID. Okay, and basically this is for unicast data. This bitmap controller is for multicast or broadcast data, whereas this partial virtual bitmap, that is per association ID, that is for unicast data. So here it looks like this. Here you can see traffic indication map, and there are the values: element ID, length, DTIM count, DTIM period, like that it will go. So here is a TIM information element in a beacon frame with DTIM period as 3. This is DTIM period as 3, which means every 3 beacon, 1 DTIM will advertised. DTIM count 2 indicating in 2 beacon time there will be a DTIM. In bitmap control field, first bit is set to 1 to indicate buffer traffic and AP is broadcast or multicast. Remaining 7 bits used as bitmap offset, which may have any value between 0 to 127, used as space shape. DTIM. So this delivery traffic indication message. So this is the sniffer packet capture for DTIM. Here you can see. So DTIM beacon is identical in structure to the ordinary beacon. There is no difference in that, but the only difference is that the content of the DTIM, i.e., will give information about broadcast or multicast traffic that is buffered at the AP. So in addition to the typical information about the buffered unicast frames that is always present in the TIM. So basically if you look at the TIM, so this TIM is used to intimate to the stations that hey, I buffered some data for you. But this DTIM is for only multicast or broadcast data. So here shows a DTIM beacon where the DTIM count is set to 0. It means that if broadcast or multicast traffic buffered at the AP, first bit of bitmap control set to 1, otherwise it will be 0. Here you can see that it's set to zero, means there is no multicast or broadcast data. So 802.11 power management. This power management is also called legacy power save mode. In this method, the station never sends a frame with the power management flag set to zero. It is always set to one. Here you can see that here this is the station and this is the AP. Here it sends that power management is equal to one. And after that, the AP started buffering the data for this particular station. Okay. Then when station returns to the DOS state, here you can see how it happens. So also when station returns to the DOS mode, it does not notify the AP, and AP has to always buffer frames intended to that particular station. When PS pole, power save pole frames are used in 802.11 power management, the station has to send a PS pole control frame to request AP to send a buffer unicast frame. In that frame, the AP set a bit called more data bit. It has to set to 1. The station understand AP has more data to send and therefore remain in awake state and send and the PS pole frame to get next frame. 802.11 power management has two major limitations. So like additional overhead added to the wireless channel, which concludes to decrease the throughput, and the station must spend too much time in transmitting state. So these are the basic two limitations of 802.11 power management. Coming to the PS pole frame, whatever we saw earlier. So let's discuss something detail about the PS pole frame. So when a client station is set for power save mode, it will shut down some of the transmissible components for a particular period of time to conserve the power. The station indicates that it is using power save mode by changing the value of the PM bit, that is power management bit, to 1 within frame control field. A station sends a null frame data frame to the AP indicating it is going to power save mode. Then the power management mode shall not change during any single frame exchange sequence. This means that the power management bit is the same for all MPDUs in an AMPDU. So this is a sniffer capture of PS pole frame. This is a type subtype, you can see it here. This is a null function, and type subtype here you can see. So station will go to sleep. Here it's set to 1. So PS pole frame looks like this. Once AP receives this PS pole frame from the station, it will buffer all unicast frame to this station. Typically, station can sleep for longer period of time and then awaken. So in time to hear an upcoming beacon which lists AID values of unicast frame buffered at the AP. Okay, this is the basic typical things. How often the station is awakened is based on a variable called LI, that is called listen interval, which I talked before. And this is usually a vendor specific implementation. When a station receives the beacon, it checks to see whether its association ID is set in the timbit, indicating that buffered unicast frame waits. If so, remains awake and send a 20 byte PSPOL frame to the AP. So this is the PSPOL frame. You can see it here how it's doing. This is the type subtype. Here you can see this is a power set pole control frame. This is subtype is TEM, and here association ID is mentioned. Here BSSID, transmitter address, all the things are mentioned here. It's saying that more data field is set to 1. Okay, so like that it's happening. So this PSPOL frame is a control frame with subtype value as 10. When AP sends the data to the station need to know when all buffered unicast data has been received, so that it can go back to the sleep mode once again. So when the station receives buffered unicast frame with the more data field set to 1, then station knows that it cannot go back to sleep because there is some more data buffer at the AP. So when more data field is set to 1, station needs to send another PSPOL frame and wait to receive next buffered unicast frame. When the more data bit will set to 0, station knows that the last buffered unicast frame, and it can go to the sleep mode once again, and it will send an acknowledgement to the AP. Here you can see the legacy power management, how it's happening. So here you can see this is the station. First of all, beacon key, then PSPOL frame, then the buffered unicast frame sent with more data bit set to 1, then egg, then again PSPOL frame, then again buffered unicast frame, and it indicated that more data bit is set to 0, then the acknowledgement. This is the final thing. Here though you can see TIM, PSPOL, egg, more data equal to 1, egg, then egg, PSPOL, egg, then more data bit equal to 0, then acknowledgement, then again client will go back to the dozing state. How the PSPOL frame recovery is happening? Basically, what happens is station is in PS mode in an ESS, initiates a frame exchange sequence by transmitting a PSPOL frame to request data from an AP. In the event that neither an ACK frame nor a data frame is received from the AP, in response to the PSPOL frame sent from the station, then station will retry the sequence of by transmitting another PSPOL frame. If the AP sends a data frame in response to a PSPOL frame but fails to receive the ACK frame acknowledging the data frame, the next PSPOL frame from the same station may cause a retransmission of the last MSDU until the relevant limit is reached. So this is how the PSPOL frame recovery happens. Then coming to the next topic is 802.11e UAPSD. So this method introduced in 802.11e amendment, and which we call a part of WMM PowerShell certification as well. So in this method, what happens, a station typically sends a null data frame in order to retrieve buffer unicast frame from the AP. Power management bit set to 0 in this frame indicating station is in active mode, so that AP will send all buffer unicast frames to the station. Here power management bit set to 0, then all the buffer data are sent from the AP to station. Then station intimated that again I am going to power management bit equal to 1, means I am going back to the power saving mode. So when the station goes into power save mode, it has to send another null data frame with power management bit set to 1. So this is all about the UAPST. N power management. Basically, 11N power management is broadly classified into two categories. The first one is PSMP, power save multipole. Second one is SMSP, special multiplexing power save. PSMP, power save multipole, what is this? This is a power management method that builds on scheduled automatic power save delivery, SAPSD, for network that use HCF control channel access, HCCA. SMSP, special multiplexing power save. SMSP involves station reducing the number of data streams used during special multiplexing. SMSP will temporarily disabling special multiplexing to conserve battery life. So this is just an overall idea. I will discuss in detail of this techniques in other slides, in my other videos. So in IBSS, how the power management is happening, here you can see. So IBSS is nothing but ad hoc network. In this, there is no AP to send TIM or DTIM. So only the station, when a station goes into power mode, power saving mode, multiple other station has to buffer its data for specific station. So in IBSS, there is another frame called Announcement Traffic Indication Message, ATIM, that is used for power management. It is a management frame with no frame body. When a station receives ATIM, that formally dozing station must begin the process of retrieving buffered frame from the stations that transmitted the ATIM. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can ask if you feel any question, you can comment also, and thanks for your support too much. If you like my video, just like it, subscribe it and click on the bell button. Thank you. Bye bye.